Broccoli doesn't get a lot of love in the vegetable world when it comes to hitting the grill. But this workaday vegetable is full of secrets and intrigue. And I've got the intriguing Ashley here. Got a little broccoli trivia for you.
Uh-oh.
What do broccoli and James Bond have in common?
Well, I know we liked martinis. broccoli martinis?
We're not going to drink broccoli today, but the answer
okay.
is Albert Broccoli.
Oh.
Albert Broccoli produced many of the James Bond films that we love today, and his family cultivated the broccoli in this country that we know and love so much.
Wow, well yeah. thank you, Albert Broccoli.
thank
and
you,
James
Albert
Bond.
Yes, here's to James Bond.
yeah. All right, so we have 2 pounds of broccoli. And as you know, if you cut the florets too small, you're just gonna have a bottom of your grill full of broccoli florets, and that's not a good thing. So we have figured out a solution for that problem. And it's important to start with broccoli that's about 6 to 7 inches long. Now I am gonna trim the end of this. I'm gonna cut this down lengthwise. And then as you see, we have some really fibrous exterior on the broccoli. And that's really difficult to get nice and tender. So I'm gonna use this vegetable peeler and peel this down about 1/8 of an inch. You're gonna see that the color starts to turn a different shade of green. And that's a good sign that you've gone through that skin. All right. Now we have over here 1/4 cup of extra virgin olive oil. 1 tablespoon of water, 3/4 teaspoon of salt, and 1/2 teaspoon of cracked black pepper. And this is going to act as the steaming liquid for the broccoli. And that'll make a little bit more sense in a second, but I'm just gonna whisk this until combined.
You saw confusion on my face.
Okay, that looks good. Now I'm just going to toss this broccoli with this oil mixture. All right, this is looking nice and coated. Now, we have 2 24-by-12-inch pieces of heavy-duty aluminum foil. These are gonna be our hobo packs. I'll show you just what I mean. I'm gonna transfer 5 per sheet of foil, and you wanna put the head on one side, the stem on the other, get it nice and close in there, and it's cut side down. And you just want to make sure that these are centered so it's easier to crimp and fold the foil. And then using the shorter sides, crimp them up together. And do the same with the bottom, and the same with the top. All of this aluminum foil is going to trap in the moisture. It's all going to steam as it grills. I'm going to transfer this to the rim baking sheet and repeat with the remaining 5 stalks. And one last thing, we have 1 lemon. I'm just going to roll it on the board here just to soften everything on the inside. And I'm going to cut this in half. We're actually going to grill these lemon halves. It acts as a finishing sauce almost.
Kind of caramelizes
yeah.
too. Great flavor.
Really good. So let's go outside and grill.
All right.
All right, Bridget, so this grill has been preheating on high for 15 minutes. I'm just going to give it a quick clean.
Always a good idea.
Yes. And just using this wad of paper towels, I'm just going to grease the grill. I'm now going to turn the burners from high to medium high, and I'm going to put the packets onto the grill. Just put them evenly on there, and I'm going to close the lid here and cook these for about 8 minutes, and I'm going to flip them halfway through cooking.
Sounds good.
All right, Bridget, it has been 8 minutes. Just transfer these to the rim baking sheet here, only because the packets are a little warm at this point. Carefully using some kitchen shears, I'm going to cut some vents away from me, allowing the steam to escape that way, not this way. Because I don't know about you, but I don't really love broccoli steam facials. At this stage, what we wanted to do was steam the broccoli mm-hmm. in these packets. With a fork, I just want to pierce it ever so slightly and meet a little bit of resistance, and that's perfect. I'm going to put the broccoli cut side down onto the grill.
Now, is this still medium-high heat?
This is still medium-high okay. heat, and this is gonna get that char that you were looking for so eagerly earlier, Bridget.
All right.
Remember the lemons from earlier?
Yes.
Okay. If we're just gonna put these cut side down, they're gonna cook for the same time as the broccoli. I'm gonna close the lid here, and I'm gonna turn the broccoli every 2 minutes for 8 minutes.
Okay.
So So it's been 8 minutes. These look lovely.
They're beautiful.
Nicely charred, beautifully green, and now.
Oh, so good.
Aren't they beautiful?
Gorgeous.
Okay, so it's almost done. We just have to go inside and put a few more finishing touches on it.
I'll eat probably this much on the way in.
Hey. All right, I'm just gonna cut these stalks into 2-inch pieces, okay, which are pretty much bite-sized.
The size of my mouth?
Yes. And now we've got those florets.
Oh.
And they didn't fall to the bottom of the grill. Now I'm gonna transfer it to this beautiful platter here. One last stalk. And then we have these beautiful grilled lemon halves. So I'm just gonna squeeze these on over the broccoli.
Looks so good.
So good. Finish with a little salt and pepper.
Okay. Always a good idea.
Always. All right, we just have a little extra virgin olive oil that I'm gonna just drizzle on over.
Oh, yes.
I have some Parmesan cheese, 1/4 cup. All right, Bridget, let's move on over because I am ready for some broccoli.
I was ready. What time is it? I was ready a long time ago.
Take florette and a stalk so it doesn't feel left out.
Take a look at this color. I mean, it's still nice, bright green broccoli, but that beautiful char on the stalks and on the florets. That's really hard to do on the florets, too. All right. Very tender.
Oh, yeah.
But not mushy.
Mm-mm.
Mm.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
It's the best of both worlds.
It really tastes grilled.
Mm-hmm. That char, and it's not too bitter. It's just so perfect.
When you started it in those little hobo packs and it was steaming,
yeah,
I was like, why take it outside?
Right.
This is why you take it outside.
That's why, yep.
Gorgeous color, gorgeous flavor. Ashley, thank you so much. Amazing grilled broccoli.
I am so glad you like it.
Finally, broccoli gets its own, wait for it, license to grill.
Oh, Bridget, that was good.
And it all starts with trimming the broccoli stalks so that they cook evenly. After tossing with seasoned extra virgin olive oil and water, seal them in tightly sealed aluminum foil hobo packs and cook them over a medium-high fire. Then place the steamed broccoli directly on those grill grates to char the exterior, along with a couple of lemon halves. Finish with a squeeze of grilled lemon and some Parmesan, and there you have it from Cook's Country. Tender, charred, and a most intriguing grilled broccoli. You can get this recipe and all the recipes from this season, along with testings, tastings, and select episodes on our website, cookscountry.com. Thanks for watching Cook's Country from America's Test Kitchen. So what'd you think?
Leave a comment and let us know which recipes you're excited to make, or just say hi.
Now you can find links to today's recipes and reviews in the video description.
And don't forget to subscribe to our channel.
See you later.
Alligator.